Hey, what's going on, everybody? Today we're not really doing anything serious, but I had a good comment on a video that for a video idea to show you a room tour. That's why you guys should always post your ideas in the comments. I try to make them happen as best I can. But yeah, if you've watched my videos for any amount of time now, and I'll go around show you guys everything, like different angles. I'm just starting the video here. If you've watched my channel for any bit of time now, you'll notice that relatively, I haven't added anything. The only thing I've added in like probably the last decade of living in this room is actually a table for my computer. Outside of that, everything has really been here the same. I did get a new desk. I had a desk since I was like a little kid, since we moved here. And it started falling apart after like 15 years or whatever. So I did get a newer desk, but still kind of the same concept. There's still a desk here. But yeah, everything's been here. Like I said, if you've been watching my videos for any amount of time now, you'll notice that I like to rearrange things. And for me, it feels like it's a good way to get like a new room feeling, a new, just different ambiance and everything with the same stuff. So what you'll notice is like right now, I have my, and like I said, I'll move you guys around here in a little bit, but I always have my windows with the light coming this way. It comes up better on camera. But a lot of the times I like to I like to move things around, and even in my videos from like last year and stuff, you'll see. Now I actually haven't really moved things around recently. It's actually been this way for quite some time now. Maybe I'm overdue for another room change, but I mean, yeah. Relatively everything here is the same. I just like to move it around. Like I said, right now I can lay on my bed, watch TV or play games. Sometimes I'll flip things and move things, and sometimes my bed will be against that wall or against this wall. I think with what I have here, unless I add or subtract things, I think I've kind of got like the best setup possible for me, and that is that, you know, my door being here. Because at one point in time, I had my bed here, and the TV was against the wall, which I like, because the only thing is, like, with my TV being like it is, the glare from the windows, you can even see it right here, comes on the TV. So I like, during the daytime, to have my windows open and just let that light in. But if I'm playing games or watching TV or anything, it really bad glare on the TV, so I can't really do that. What I have to do traditionally is put my bed against that wall and then do the TV against that one. The problem is, when I like it, again, if people come in here or whatever, I like that they can walk in, or even me as just living here, I can go right over to my gun safe if I want to grab a gun to show somebody. Like, there's a walkway here. I could just go right to my computer. I can go right to the gun safe. I could sit at the foot of the bed and play games. I could lay, like, for serious games, casual games, I can lay down. I have access to everything. So the point of this beginning ramble here is that I traditionally like to move things around just because, like I said, it makes it feel like it's a different room with the same stuff. And I think I've kind of found a really good layout here, I think is the best way I can put it. So I don't think I'll be moving it around anymore. Like I said, the only thing I don't like is the glare on the TV. But then if I have a queen-size bed here. So if I have my bed essentially it's about the same length as this bureau. So imagine where this bureau is would be where my bed is. And then I always like to have like a nightstand or something. So realistically, like if anyone was to walk in here, you'd have to kind of shimmy along the bed to get around it. And it's nice for like just me, but then anytime somebody wants to come in the room or do anything, or even like, let's say I'm in a hurry and I'm trying to get something from my closet or my gun safe, now I have to walk all the way around the bed, and then like you have to come around, which, yeah, not a fan of. So that's my little introduction to this video here. I think it's just, I think we got a good layout, but yeah, I think we'll just start with that. I guess while I'm here, what the heck, I'll start from this section of the room, and then we'll kind of go around it a little bit, show you things up more like in depth. All right, so I'm going to try this. We're going to try to kind of boop our way around the room here. Starting off, obviously my bed is in the corner over here. So we have my handy dandy Blue Yeti, which is recording this video that you're listening to now. Next to my bed, so traditionally I have I feel like everyone needs a junk drawer. It's just literally full of like, I consider it organized junk. Like I could tell you what's in there without looking. But for the most part, it's just junk. Got a handy dandy flashlight next to my bed because, you know, why not? Got the iPad, which when I was younger, I used to use the iPad like a lot more, but now I feel like when the iPad first came out, I don't really use it very often now. Typically what I'll do is I'll have a video game playing in the background, like while I'm playing something, like Minecraft, for example, where there's not like a whole lot of noise going on, and I'll do a pop-up a YouTube video on there to listen to while I play. I got both of them. I got AirPods and Beats, just, you know, I feel like a lot of the times just sitting back listening to some music is always nice, so got a couple different options there. I'm more a fan of just the AirPods. They're like, because they're low profile. The Beats do sound nicer, but like I said, I just like the low profile. I can take those AirPods in my pocket anywhere kind of thing. And yeah, I have my original iHome clock. It is still going strong after God knows how many years. The on top there, that is designed to charge a iPod Touch, just to kind of put it in perspective on how old this one is. So it's still going strong. I mean, realistically, I just need something that tells the time. I don't know what it is, but like when I'm sleeping, if I wake up in the night, especially if it's a work night. Obviously, if I'm off and I can sleep until whenever, it doesn't matter. But like, if I wake up and it's dark outside, I can't just go back to bed. I have to know what time it is. I don't know why, but it sort of is what it is. So like, if I wake up and see it's 2 a.m, like I'm like, okay, I can go back to bed. But if I wake up and it's 6 a.m, then like I really can't go back to sleep at that point. Like my body just will not let me, just because I'm so close to being able to go to sleep, or waking up at that point. Like, I don't know, I'm weird. Right there I have a little notebook. I have a lot of video ideas in there. Anytime something comes to mind, I just kind of scribble it down. I've faced it facing down right now, so you can't really see it. Next to it, I have it's miscellaneous gun parts in that drawer there. And that's sort of my, I hate people that call it everyday carry stuff. Like, I'll watch YouTube videos where they're like, oh my, these are my everyday carry loadouts, and then they just start whipping out, like, their car keys and, like, just useless garbage, their wallet. Like, that's not, yes, you are, I mean, I guess you're literally carrying it, but I don't consider that an everyday carry sort of stuff. So that's my everyday stuff. Got a couple watches that I like to frequent. Wallet, keys, a little pepper spray sometimes I like to carry. Sunglasses, and that's just a miscellaneous pick rail that broke. Moving on, I have, if I can kind of quietly do this, maybe. I have my main desk, decided to upgrade to 2 monitors. Oh, you can see me there a little bit. I decided to recently upgrade to 2 monitors. It just makes editing videos so much easier. Like being able to have one tab open for like my video files and then another tab open for like DaVinci Resolve to actually do the editing makes it really, really nice. Got a little, I don't know what you call those, boom arms? I really don't know. For the Blue Yeti microphone. Sometimes if I'm doing something that involves the computer, I can just record the audio right off the computer. Got miscellaneous. I have a lot of, wherever my finger's at, I have a lot of like LED lights like overhead in my room, and then my computer's LED and stuff, so got a couple LED switches there. There's me. Hi. Also, I love Legos, especially Star Wars Legos. I don't have any. I used to have like a big tall shelf that had all of them in them. Fortunately, I had, well, unfortunately, I had a girlfriend that did not like me displaying my Legos. Reason 1 million why I left her. But she made me get rid of that shelf that had all the Legos on it, so majority of my Legos are in a bin right now. But I have occasional Lego sets that I've rebuilt since I broke up with her, and they're kind of, you know, out there, just wherever I can find space. And then underneath, typically what you'll see, if I can kind of set this up a little bit, typically anytime I film like a video like this, where I'll be like showing you something, I actually have a, basically a shelf that goes across here to my bed, and I'll just record it underneath here. And then what I'll do is, that box, I have a lot of boxes with just random stuff. But I'll record it on top of that box there. See if I can kind of move on here. I'm going to be playing Ring Around the Extension Cables with this video here. So, starting off, we have my Ender 3 3D printer. The only thing I've made on it at all is a little Hand of the King logo from Game of Thrones. Basically, like, when you think of buying something, especially like this, you have like big ideas. You're like, oh, well, I could, like one of the things that came to mind is my car has little like tweeters on it. And, I thought of making like a little bracket because they don't fit the original spot of those tweeters like perfectly. So I thought you could just make one with the, 3D printer. Still never got around to it. I probably could, but I never got around to it. So a lot of big ideas with it, but never actually went anywhere with any of those ideas. So that's the only thing I printed as sort of like a test, and I have not touched it since. Moving on, we have a nice pile of absolute garbage. I feel like I have a lot of these piles, but this is like the more used garbage, if that makes any sense whatsoever. Got some plush Chick-fil-A cows, got some miscellaneous snacks, I got like a portable charger, I use that like when I'm playing Pokemon Go, pens, screwdrivers, random nonsense. Up top here, this is a fine balance of balancing wires, as you can see here. Just an aerial view of my junk. Over here, these are my three real big guns that I actually carry all the time. And I got little like Glock bags that I can put them in, like if they're just going in my car or whatever, or just depending on the application. I carry a Glock 19 with a light. That one right there is for, like, traditionally that's my winter carry, like when I'm wearing a hoodie or a big jacket or something. And it also becomes darker later, so even when I'm going to dinner, it's usually dark out, so I need a light. My sort of mid-size carry, which I still need a holster for, but I just kind of pocket carry that right now. The Glock 43X with the Shield Arms mag and the TLR7 light. And then my main carry gun that I've carried for many, many years now is the 365. It has the 10-round magazine in it right now, just because it's kind of, I have trouble, especially in my summer clothes, like, hiding a gun. So I have a 12-round magazine, but usually the 10-round works very well with me. Backing it up a little bit here, we have some Old Dominion root beer. They just decided to go out of business, and my buddy works at a distribution, I forget what it's called, it's literally called NKS, but distributions, but he got me a couple of these great big old cases. I don't know what you want to call them. I guess cases is a fine word. Got me a couple cases of root beer. That's the last they'll probably ever make. Now, I guess there's rumor that they're going to get bought and potentially just rebranded under a different name, but I just got a whole mess right here just in case. As you can see, I'm currently drinking one. Just, they are really good. It's like one of the only root beers I really like. Underneath here, we have a smorgasbord of, we have my PlayStation VR. It's currently in a box right now. And that's really because it comes out from time to time, but I can only handle it in, like, intervals. And realistically, it hurts my eyes after a while, and there's a lot of wires and cable management you have to do, so I'll bring it out from time to time, but for the most part, it just stays in its box. Underneath of it is my PlayStation 4. It's seen many, many a good days before the PlayStation 5 came out. Got a smorgasbord of PlayStation and Switch games there. I got my Xbox One, or what is it, the Xbox, no, S. I've always been a PlayStation guy. The only reason I really got that was because I really wanted Halo Infinite to be a COD killer. Like, as you can see, I mean, I like Call of Duty. I always have, since Call of Duty Big Red 1 for the PlayStation 2. But I just really wish Call of Duty, like, would innovate recently. They don't, so I kind of just, I was hoping that they would change, and they would have someone to compete with. And so I bought an Xbox. That's the only Xbox I've ever owned to play it, and the game sucked, in my opinion. So, like, one of the only memories I have from Halo Infinite was absolutely mag dumping on a guy. We were having a very serious gunfight, and then he just turns a corner and just leaves the gunfight and heals up. Like, it was pretty dumb. Over here I have a smorgasbord of Wii, Wii U, and DS games. A lot of fun. Back over there in my drawer of junk is my 3DS, somewhere over that direction. I have just random rifle cases everywhere, just because, depending on if I'm taking, like, maybe I'm taking, like, a lot of handguns to the range, no rifles, or whatever combination I'm doing, it really depends. So different cases are needed for different applications. Just miscellaneous shoes. You'll see from time to time, back in high school, I did a junior ROTC, and that's all my ribbons and whatnot from it. A lot of good times there. We were absolutely goofballs. I made it to, I was the Corps Commander. If you know anything about it, I was in charge of about 150 cadets. Just like I said, really good time in my life. A lot of fun memories of just, like I said, goofing off after school, before school, and I have so many good stories to tell about that, but that's my nice little shadow box of all my ribbons and everything. Got my random shoes. I have my, that's my plaque for, the glare doesn't overly do it. If you need to see anything up close or anything, I can always shout it out in a future video. That is my vigil. I was in the Boy Scouts. I got my Eagle Scout, and that right there is for Order of the Arrow. If you know anything about it, it's kind of like the Honor Society of Boy Scouts is how they kind of put it. I made Vigil, which is the highest rank you can make there. And that's my little plaque for it. If you'll notice the theme, you'll see I have a lot of medals there. You got the ribbons for free, but I bought the medals just to kind of be that guy. Made an absolute mess, and like the noise walking down the hallways with all those medals was quite something. But if you can, I think I have enough room with my cables here, but if you read that, my vigil name, you have a name that's given in, yes, the Indian name given to me is Makliamak Enemen Wadile, which translates to one with a chest full of medals. So even in Boy Scouts, I had a lot of medals on my chest. Just good times, good times. Got my mini fridge with a bunch of random stickers from things like places I buy things and whatnot. Got the PlayStation just on top of the mini fridge, because why not? This is an absolute stupid setup I have right going right now with like extension cables and whatnot. But here's my TV. I have a bunch of junk on top as well, but I have a lot of old my PlayStation, Xbox, and Switch controllers. My Switch is behind the TV right now. Not currently playing anything on it, but when I am, I'll move it to the front. Down below, I have drawers full of just clothes, nothing fancy there. Down below, I have a range bag. I'm constantly going to the range, so that's full of, right now I just have it full of, like, 9mm ammo. It's obviously got, like, hearing protection, glasses. I have enough for, like, a couple people to go to the range. And really, that's just because, like, at any point in time, we could, it's nice to just buy a gun from the gun store and kind of just go right to the range sometimes. Or people forget things or whatever, so that's always loaded up with some goodies. I can just, like at any given time, if we're just relaxing and someone's like, hey, you guys want to go shooting? And we can just very easily grab the bag, grab some guns, and go. I have my, just some rifles out right now just to kind of clear out some room in the gun safe. Obviously, the Barrett is, it does not fit. I have a Winchester safe that is, 57 inches tall. It does not fit assembled, so I have to take it apart to put it in there, and even then it takes up the room of like 3 guns, so usually I just have it out. That's its Pelican case underneath of it. I just have it out unless I'm going somewhere, then I'll put it away, but usually it just sits right there. Moving our way on over here to the actual gun safe itself, I have a lot of crap on top. I got some black powder in that box, just some magazines. In all those boxes up top there are ammo, like spare mags. I got my 500 Smith & Wesson holster, just some extra magazines right on top, and then my black powder lead balls. In the safe itself, we have just like some smaller guns in the door. My middle pouch there, I have like just some takedown stuff, just miscellaneous like parts and stuff. In the safe itself, if you can see, I have all of my handguns kind of, I'm really hitting the limit of the safe here. I have all those boxes are in, well, the big box is Palmetto lowers, and then I have some arrow lowers and like an arrow 9mm lower. Just uncompleted lowers that I'll get to one day kind of thing. Moving my way down here, we have some smaller rifles on the one side, and then the big, tall, long rifles. They actually actually stick out to the top for some of them. Still looking for 405 Winchester. Maybe one day. So I could shoot that one gun. Closet, nothing serious. Just my old like camping stuff up top. Just clothes. Like I said, nothing serious. I just have some, like there's a paintball gun, my old karate belts, some Lego boxes, just junk, really. Mustang parts. I got my saxophone in there somewhere. And then I even have like my old Nerf swords and Nerf guns and stuff. Just junk I haven't touched in a long time, but I'm not getting rid of it. So, way too many memories. Moving over here, so a little, I guess behind the scenes, if you've stayed this long, is I don't usually show this corner, and that's because I do well with messes, like organized messes kind of thing. These are clothes that I wear like a lot. There's no point, like in my opinion, there's no point in putting them away if I'm just gonna wear them next week or whatever, or a couple days, whatever it may be. So I always have a clothes pile. I've always had a clothes pile, and if I ever do clean it up, like once a year I'll clean it up, it just comes right back. So no real point in cleaning the clothes pile unless people are coming over or something and they want a house tour, but there's always a clothes pile. As I finagle my way over here, I have a bunch of Baja Blast now that they no longer sell it, so I can enjoy it throughout the winter time. Stocking up. Got some miscellaneous Lego sets. I always have the need. I sleep with a ceiling fan and a standing fan just because I like the, I love the noise and I love the cold. I keep both of them on like a lower setting. It's not really cold per se, but it's definitely, look at this, live in action, UPS man coming to ruin my video. Then the dog's gonna start barking and look at this nonsense. All right, well, I will cut and, because the dog's gonna start barking any minute now, I'll cut and we'll be right back. Alrighty, so ignore the Blue Yeti over here. I just have to record somewhere. This right here is where I keep a lot of my collections, collectible stuff. We're gonna start off at the very top. I have some, my Funko Pop collection, my Mountain Dew collection, I have my Lego Death Star, as you can see, like Lego Yoda, just some Lego sets up there, and just some collections. I have a couple more Lego sets on this drawer here. Moving our way down, this is my Pokemon drawer, or whatever you want to call it. It's got my jumbo cards, my old like Game Boy, my like Pokemon Go ball and wristband. I got some old the old original Game Boy games. In those drawers is some like extra Pokemon cards. You could see like right there's like my Nintendo 64 expansion slot. So just like memory cards and stuff like that. It's all sort of like gaming related. There's a drawer behind the ammo for like paperwork and boring stuff. Over here I have miscellaneous Pokemon cards, like a lot of duplicates and stuff. I have all my, I'll do a close-up after this, but I have all my minifigures from, like, Pokemon boxes, Pokemon card boxes. I have behind there my older Pokemon cards, so if you know anything about the generations, it's like it started with Gen 1, so my 1 and 2, like, 2 generation cards, so the original stuff's in there, Gen 3, 4, 5, 6, that's promo cards. In the bottom, I have Gen 7 and 8 down there, so the current cards. Right there is a bunch of like my Boy Scout patches in there, in the, wherever my finger's at, I gotta aim really different. In here is just more junk that I don't ever touch, but I don't really feel like getting rid of it. I really don't. We have the my organized, see if I can kind of angle it maybe, I don't know, my ammo. There's no real rhyme or reason to this, just like my 22 shorts, my 5.56, And one of the things I've mentioned in videos is, like, a lot of the times, I just recently finally stacked up on 9mm, but I'm really low on 5.56. A lot of the times I'll stack, like, so, where's my finger at on this video? So, like, I've been really stacking up on 32 Smith & Wesson Long. I've got a lot of 44 Specials, plenty of 500 Magnums, plenty of 303 British. Where's my fingers? See if I can, I'll just rotate myself. Plenty of 303 British. I don't even have a 300 Blackout, but I got ammo for it. Got more 45-70 than I possibly could use. Like 222. I got like weird calibers up here. So then I tend to neglect, like my 5.56. Down, that's just sort of how I have it laid out. Each one's a, you know, a caliber. Down at the bottom there. So down here, you'll see I have one box of 45 to my name. So same thing, I tend to negate calibers I really shouldn't. Just have like miscellaneous stuff, like that's all my 5.7, my 7.62 by 39s in the back. Got a bunch of 308, like my 50 BMG, like 22, like just random stuff. The stuff up here I'm trying to like get more of. I'm trying to make sure I constantly have like, to be honest, I need some more 50 Beowulf because like the top box is low. But this is stuff I'm just constantly like trying to keep stocked up, keep having plenty of. From the top view, just more junk. I got my Zen Fountain, like old masks when we needed those. Got some extra Pokemon code cards. I guess the top code has probably been taken, but you can have it, I guess. Obsidian Flames. Yeah, you can have that code if somebody wants it. Up close, I guess, real quick, it's my Pokemon drawer. We got, let me move some stuff here. Cable management. It's all about cable management. Got my Pokemon minifigures. I guess I could show you in here real quick. This is my, I don't know what you call it, drawer, but got some old, like, some snow globes, my Eagle Scout medal that I got, my old class ring. My other watches, I have a nice little display for them, but never use them. Got all my, these are Chris Bears from Swarovski. They are absolutely beautiful. I love them. Me and my ex collected them a lot. I need to get back into it. They're a little on the pricier side, but they are beautiful little guys. Really cool stuff. All right, so I think that's kind of the basics of my room, just like sort of the big collections, gun collection, Pokemon, Legos, ammo. Yeah, I think that's about video games. Yeah, that's pretty much the gist of it. I guess that'll be probably the end of this video, if you stuck around. Hope you all enjoyed. If there's anything else you want to see up close or see more in depth, let me know. I think I kind of hit like everything pretty generically. And then things like my Pokemon cards, I've already made videos about, like going into more detail. I think that's pretty much the gist of it. If you have any other video ideas or anything you want to see more in depth, let me know. Like I said, this video here was a commented suggestion, so I try to make it happen. And I guess I'll catch you guys in the next video. Peace.